on the new Talk Radio 1450 WCTC, the voice of Central Jersey. From politics to entertainment, from social issues to lifestyles, from newsmakers to pop culture. If it's Jersey, it's on Jersey Central with Bert Barron, 732-545-9282. Or toll free at 888-545-9282. Your state, your home, your voice. Jersey Central with Bert Barron on the new Talk Radio 1450 WCTC.
It is 8:37. We're back on Jersey Central on the new Talk Radio 1450 WCTC, the voice of Central Jersey. Good morning to you. It's Bert. We'll do our need-to-know things coming up a little bit later on here in this 8:30 half hour of the show. I want to get to my special guest who was on the Jersey Central Newsmaker Hotline. And if you recall, at the end of December when I did my special year in review program with Susan Bloom, who is a renowned Jersey writer and columnist, talked to me and told me about a great organization that you did a story on recently. So I wanted to spotlight them this morning here on WCTC. The group is called Moms Helping Moms, and they do some great work here in New Jersey. And they have a very special event that is coming up a little bit later on this month that we want to give you all the information on. So joining me this morning on the Jersey Central Newsmaker Hotline is the founder of Moms Helping Moms here in Jersey. We have Bridget Cutler, who was with us here on WCTC. Hey, Bridget, good morning. It's Bert Barron. How are you?
Hi, Bert. I'm great. How are you?
Good. Good to speak to you today. Thanks for taking some time to speak with us. And I want to give some information about your event that's happening later on in January. But for people that are hearing about Moms Helping Moms and the great work that you do, can you just kind of give us an overview of what the foundation does?
Absolutely. Moms Helping Moms is a diaper and baby supply bank located in North Jersey. We do serve all of New Jersey. And essentially, we're like a food bank, except instead of food, we're giving out diapers and wipes and clothing and books and basically any essential that you can think of that a baby would need up to the age of five.
And I'm sure you'll agree with me, Bridget. I think that every baby in New Jersey, whether rich, poor, whatever, you need to get off to a good, healthy start. And you know what? Sometimes just reaching out to somebody to get some assistance with basically the basics of raising an infant here in our state, having a resource like yours, I can't imagine the positive difference that you've made in the lives of so many people, whether it's families or the babies themselves. It's got to be just remarkable what you've been able to accomplish to this point.
Well, thank you, Bert. We appreciate that. And really, that was the foundation for this organization, was that we all feel that every child deserves a fair start, deserves a healthy start, and deserves a chance to be happy and healthy. And we hope to be able to provide that for any child that needs it in New Jersey. And we have a long way to go, but we're getting there.
I think people like numbers, Bridget, when they can hear about numbers. Do you have any figures that you could share about perhaps maybe pounds of food or numbers of diapers or packages of baby wipes that you've been able to help people get over the years? Do you have some statistics you can share?
Absolutely, Bert. And I'm an ex-CPA, so I also love numbers.
Oh, you took time away from tax season to talk to me today. I appreciate that, too.
So just this past year, 2017, we distributed over 150,000 diapers.
Wow.
And hundreds of thousands of other items that I mentioned earlier to over 11,000 individuals from low-income families in New Jersey. So that was just 2017.
That's remarkable. And I'm sure from every corner of the state, the demand is probably not getting any less, Bridget. It's probably getting more and more with each year as this foundation exists. The demand is probably getting greater, isn't it?
Absolutely. While we do our best, we are a small organization, and we know there are so many families out there that we're not reaching, and we're just working our hardest to get to as many of them as we can. But the demand is huge.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. And congratulations also on the foundation. Did I see that you were featured on CNN Heroes? You got some national recognition with that?
I was, yes. Thank you so much. That was a couple of years ago. That was really amazing. I believe it was 2013, and it brought a lot of attention to our organization. And it was really just such an honor for them to have chosen me for that.
Yeah, well-deserved. Well-deserved, definitely. Bridget Cutler is our guest this morning here on WCTC. She is the founder of a very vital group in New Jersey, based here in Central New Jersey, but they really help out statewide. It is called Moms Helping Moms, and they're basically a supply and diaper bank for low-income families who are just kind of struggling to get through day-to-day. I mean, imagine being a brand new baby, a brand new child in this world, and it's you don't even have anything that you could use to change a diaper or to give this kid any sort of comfort on a day-to-day basis, and to just have a resource like Moms Helping Moms is just a wonderful thing to have. And the whole Moms Helping Moms thing, Bridget, is this mostly run by women and supported by women, or do you get help from a lot of different people?
The day-to-day operations are, you know, our core volunteers and our employees, we all do happen to be women, and most of us are moms. However, our larger volunteer base and our supporters and our donors, you know, it's all across the board. We have men and women of, you know, all ages, with children, without children. It's kind of an easy cause to get behind. Everybody wants to support kids and help them have a healthy life.
Yeah, and even on your website, MomsHelpingMomsFoundation.org, which I urge everybody to visit, you talk about a couple of different ways that people can help out and kind of make a difference. If someone listening today wanted to kind of put together a diaper drive and be able to accept donations of diapers to get to your foundation, how difficult is it to set something up like that?
It's so easy. We actually have on our website a diaper drive toolkit, and it gives you all of the information that you would need to set up your own diaper drive, host your own drive, how to get the diapers to us afterwards, and we're always available as well if there's additional questions. So all of that information is on our website that you just stated. It's www.momshelpingmomsfoundation.org. We try to make this as easy as possible for everybody, and we've had some really great feedback on diaper drives that have been hosted for us.
Awesome. And volunteer opportunities also, Bridget, if someone wanted to volunteer with your organization somehow, they can do so?
Absolutely. Again, that information is on the website. We do have regular volunteer hours during the week, as well as every second Saturday of every month. And once a month, we do an evening volunteer event. It's called a sip and sort, where we get a little bit of wine and we sort some donations and we chat and we have a good time. So
a sip and sort. I like that. There you go.
Boy, do
you know how to get helpers, that's for sure, and with some wine there. That's very cool. And on the website, the next one is coming up on January 10th. If you visit the website, MomsHelpingMomsFoundation.org, you can get the information on that. We have about a little less than a minute to go, Bridget. The Snowball that's coming up, is that your biggest fundraising event of the year? And talk about what that's all about.
It is. So the Snowball is our big annual fundraiser. We really depend on that event for, you know, our yearly funding. It's going to take place this year on January 27th, Saturday, at Shackamax and Country Club in Scotch Plains. It is an evening event. Starts at 7 o'clock. There's going to be a sit-down dinner, some games, a silent auction. It's going to be a lot of fun. It always is. We have a DJ. We have a photo booth. So we hope that people will come out and support us and learn about us and just have a good time. It's
beautiful.
A really great event.
Yeah, get some information on that and tickets and also sponsorship opportunities as well. Again, it's all at the website, which is very well put together and very easy to navigate. It's Moms HelpingMomsFoundation.org. Get information on the Snowball that is coming up and just kind of a general overview and also about some other events that are coming up as well. Bridget, thank you again for your time today. I hope that 2018 is the biggest and most successful year for Moms Helping Moms, and it's incredible work that you're doing with families here in New Jersey. So thank you for the time this morning. All right.
Thank you so much, Burr. We really appreciate it.
All right. My pleasure. Thank you very much. And again, that website is MomsHelpingMomsFoundation.org. Log on and get involved, all right? Jersey